help me to explain to your children, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that all the suffering, the pain, the sadness, the bitterness that we feel is only coming from sins. You think Hamas would have the power to break through the fence, knock out our communication, murder 1,400 Jews, rape, pillage, spit on dead bodies, chop body parts? I don't even want to get into it, yo. You think they'd have that power? Not in a billion years. Not in a billion years. The only reason why Hamas had the power to perpetrate such crimes was because we were lacking in our holiness as a nation, yo. You better believe that, yo. And if you don't believe me, come, let's read. We'll go right to the book of Prophets, the book of Kings, the Torah itself will tell you. Just go read the blessings and the curses. It'll tell you right there everything you need to know. Bechukotai. You follow my laws, you'll be blessed. You'll dwell securely in the land. You'll eat from fattened calves. And life will be perfect, full with relief, success, and blessings. Just like we say in Brachat HaMazon. Yo, let me tell you something right now. Eat bread every day, 5 times a day. Why? You can say, oh, it's fattening, it's hard to digest. I don't care. Just from the merit of saying Brachat HaMazon 5 times a day, don't worry, you won't get fat, bro. The opposite. That bread will strengthen you to get stronger. What a beautiful prayer, man. Asking God to bless us. May He heal us. May He make peace amongst us. May He break the yoke of oppression speedily from our neck. May He lead us speedily upright to our land. But don't forget, may He be glorified to us forever. May He be praised on heaven and earth. May He bless each one of us with His great name, just as our forefathers Avram, Yitzhak, and Yaakov were blessed. Amen. Can you hear that song? Hashem, what a blessing. Go read the blessing you say for a guest if you're staying in somebody's house and you have the merit to read Berachat HaMazon. Go read the blessing for the guest, that he should have diamonds and rubies and pearls and all such jewels on his table. May his table will never go empty. May the fruit taste sweet. Something like this. You know, just a beautiful blessing. Berachat HaMazon. One of my favorite prayers. And then always say, you know, here's something so beautiful, yo. So when you go to the restroom, right, you're supposed to say Asher Yatzar, right? Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who formed man in wisdom, created within him numerous orifices and cavities, and it's known through the throne of your glory that if one of them were to be open or one of them were to be blocked, it would be impossible to exist even for a short while. Blessed are you, Lord, who heals all flesh and performs wonders. Amen. Hashem, I love you so much, yo. So I was telling one of my friends, no, I'm not saying this prayer, it's way too long. I said, no problem. Just say thank you, God, for letting me go to the bathroom, and you good. No, you have to say the bracha. I said, who told you that? No, that's the rule. I guess I didn't say it. No, it's too long. Okay, so I'm telling you, if it's too long and you can't do it, better you do this. Better you do this. Trust me when I tell you, bro. The Jews have to try to get closer to God, yo. That's it, man. I wish and pray, man. Hashem came to me right now and said to me, what do you want? That's what I want. I want B'nai Israel to get closer to God. Because when we're close to God, we're protected. When we're close to God, our enemies have fear in their heart. When we're close to God, we're sated. When we're close to God, we can see our children play on the street and not worry. Yo, I can't even imagine that we dealt with all this garbage for the last 20, 30 years. Rockets falling on our heads, suicide bombers, kidnapping soldiers, murdering people, blowing up pizzerias, yo. Like, and we just dealt with it, yo. And we're still just dealing with it, yo. Really, the truth is, if Israel really wanted to, bro, they could go into Gaza and destroy the place completely. Force the Palestinians to go to Egypt, if not bomb Egypt. They can go crazy and fix this problem. They don't want to, because they're afraid what the international community is going to say. And that's an embarrassment and a shame. You cannot allow people to come through rape, murder, pillage your daughters and just say, we're going to dismantle Hamas. Nah, that's not going to work. You have to get rid of everybody in Gaza, everybody in the West Bank. I know it sounds crazy. People go, oh, it's too extreme. No, it's not. No, it's not. When you have an enemy amongst you, you must root it out. It's your life or their life, bro. I'm telling you. Israel's not going to do it because they don't have God in their heart like that. Yo, but if they did, that's exactly what they would do. And they would tell them, kill the hostages, yo. Don't worry about it. This way we're going to bury you even deeper. You understand? Really, like that. I know that sounds so, like, controversial to say it like that, but I'm telling you, like that. Like that, yo. Pray, man. Just have the all the children in Klal Yisrael pray for the hostages, for Hashem to do some kind of a miracle, yo. Like some kind of a COVID breaks out and everyone dies except for the Jews. He could do it like that, yo. You think he can? Go ask Sisera what he did to him and his 185,000 soldiers. And the most beautiful thing was he burned them, but he didn't, like, let their clothes burn. He burned their soul. So they died from, like, a heavenly fire, but they didn't burn. So why? You know why? Because they came from Yefet. And Yefet covered his father's nakedness. So Hashem covered their nakedness. Because if he would have let them burn, they would be there naked without clothes. How beautiful is that, yo? Hashem is no joke, yo. Even to Sisera and his wicked army that came to destroy the Jews, he still gave them schut where they deserved it. That's what makes Hashem the most amazing. He'll pay you bijuk what you deserve. But if you could be the most wicked and evil, like here, one of these Hamas terrorists, would God forbid be in the middle of, yo, I'm not even gonna say it, yo, just committing a horrible act on a girl, and in the middle of the act he stops and tries to convince the other Hamas terrorists not to do the same to her. He gives them a speech and they walk away, and he goes in the corner and he cries till he dies. I'll go to heaven. You think I'm bugging? I'm not, bro. You don't understand. It's crazy, yo. The way I just broke it down. Go read the story of Eliezer Ben Dordea, who was with every prostitute in the world, yo. And then finally woke up. I'll tell you the story, yo, because it's dope. So he's with every prostitute, and there was one that he wasn't with, so he, like, traveled. God knows how long to see her, yo. So he went and he saw her. They did what they had to do. And then when they were done, she burped. And she looked at him with, like, this look of a demon. And out of nowhere, she just looked at him and she said, just like this burp will never return to my mouth, so to you will never return to God. And she banged on the table. Yo, he got up in shock, yo, but he realized that God used this woman to give him a message. So he ran outside. He looks up and he sees the mountain. So he goes, oh mountains, pray for me. You know, he's not a religious guy. He doesn't know what to do. Pray for me. So the mountains looked at him and said, pray for you. We're too busy praying for ourselves. So he looked at the moon. Oh moon, please pray for me. The moon gave him the same answer. The sun, the same answer. Finally, he learned that he has to pray for himself. So he looked up to the heavens with the most contrite, broken heart. And he said, God, I'm so sorry, yo, that I defiled your covenant of circumcision, that I didn't respect you, that I gave into my animalistic desires over loving you spiritually. And I'm so sorry. And he started to cry. And he cried till he died. And there was a bako when his neshama went up to Shamayim. Welcome, Rabbi Eliezer Ben Dordea. You understand what I'm telling you? That's the power of Tshuva. It's deep and it's real. But I'm going to let you know right now, if Klal Yisrael united, if all the lefty Jews, all like Nature Carter tomorrow, no, we're wrong, we shouldn't be protesting with the Palestinians, maybe we don't agree with the Zionist state, but we should go about it different. You know, things like this start changing. The lefties start changing. Secular Jews become more religious. Religious Jews become even more religious. Yo, I love what it says, that the Mashiach will make the righteous repent. What a dope line, yo. Why? What do you mean that he's righteous? Why does he have to repent? Because even the righteous sin. What do you think, yo? You were wicked from your youth. You were made from dust of the earth, prone to sin, prone to evil. You have to fight to get over that, yo. You have to want it like you want life, yo. You have to fight for it like you want life, yo. She will reduce you to a loaf of bread, yo. Yo. It's amazing, bro. You could be promiscuous, go and have relations with a bunch of girls and think it's all love. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm not hurting anybody, but you're releasing evil spirits that are entering your brain and that are attaching themselves to your soul. And that could affect your prayers. It could affect your fortune. It could affect a lot of things, yo. My advice to Klal Yisrael is to get back to God immediately, yo. If you're an atheist, arrogant Jew, fall on your hands and knees and beg God for forgiveness. Tell him how unappreciative you were, how evil you were. And by the way, just so you know, having relations before you get married is considered evil in the eyes of God. Think about it. Er and Onan died. Why? Because they did what was evil. They weren't even Jews. Non-Jews, and they died for being promiscuous. Some of them were spilling their sperm on the ground so their wife didn't get pregnant because he wanted to maintain her beautiful body. They were into sex crimes, you understand? And for that, they got killed. And God said God killed them because what they did was evil in the eyes of God. And they're non-Jews. Wake up. Meaning a non-Jew is not even allowed to be like that. You understand? Let alone a holy Jew. You know, I think about October 7th, yo. And I heard something the other day that made me so sad, yo. I was talking about some of the victims of October 7th that survived. We're getting tattoos to memorialize that day. And that really hurt me, yo. Because that's obviously against the Torah. And you should know that you're not allowed to get tattoos. No one ever says why, yo. Which I find very interesting. Say you can't have it, fine, but at least tell them why. Because the idol worshippers used to tattoo their idols on their body. That's why Hashem doesn't want you doing that. It reminds him of the idol worshippers, you understand? So out of respect for Hashem, you don't do it. Just like looking at a rainbow, not allowed to enjoy for a bit. Why? Because that rainbow is a symbol that God had to destroy the world. When Hashem looks at the rainbow, he's not happy and smiling. The opposite, he's sad that he had to kill his own children. You understand? That's why you look at it, you say a prayer. Blessed are you, Lord, our God, who made a covenant with the world to never destroy it again with a flood. You know, it's amazing. People see rainbows, they get excited, they take pictures, even a selfie. And they don't understand that the fact that this rainbow popped up right here means that this place should have been destroyed. But only because of the covenant that God made with the world did he spare this very place. So the people of that place, instead of laughing and singing and dancing with the rainbow, should be shaking and running to do tshuva. It's the only thing that's going to save us, yo, from Hamas, from this, from that, whatever it is, from our enemies, yo, is just getting close to God. Not being corrupt, not doing evil things. By the way, if you want to know what's the one thing that Hashem hates the most, the idol worshipping, the sex crimes, the breaking Shabbat, the this, the that, you know what's the thing he hates the most, is corruption and injustice, man. He hates that, yo, hates that, because it destroys all three pillars of the world, the justice, the truth, and the peace. That's why I always tell myself when I hear these people drive down the block over here with their modified mufflers and it's loud and it's arrogant and it's rude. And I keep thinking to myself, man, yo, Hashem is going to destroy these people. They have no idea how rude and arrogant that is. You know why? Because it disturbs the peace. There's no truth in it and there's no justice in it. That's why. If you have a modified muffler, fix it. Turn it off. I don't know. Do whatever you have to do, yo. That car that you drive around in, oh so proudly with, you get buried in that car. You understand? Yo, and to all these people ripping down these posters, yo, let me tell you something, man.
You ripped down a poster of a little baby that was kidnapped by Hamas. Your baby's going to get kidnapped by demons. You understand, man? You better be careful, bro. You're going to rip down pictures of people getting kidnapped? You might get kidnapped. You better be very careful. Your karma does not discriminate, bro. The karma will get you, and it will get you good, yo. It will reduce you to ashes, you understand? Stop ripping down these posters, yo. Because when you do it, it's bringing curses on your head from Shamayim, yo. Big ones, vicious ones, yo. And you look at the people that rip down the posters, yo. Come on, man. Come on, man. One of these people are going to get murdered, yo. I'm telling you right now, man. This one guy's going to have a bad day. And he's going to say something. And he's going to kill one of these people, yo. You're going to head stomp one of these guys to hell, yo. And you're going to see it, yo. You're going to see it. Hashem is going to show the world that he's not approving of this, yo. Better be very careful when you rip down posters. Now you're going to rip down 250 of them. And you know what the craziest thing is, yo? Leave these people to God, yo. Leave these people to God. God has the power, yo, just to give them a stomach ache and murder them, yo. Just that alone. Put you in a hospital for 10 years, yo. Barely breathing, you understand? He doesn't need anybody to head stomp anybody, yo. But I'm just saying, yo, I could see a head. I could see some Jew who, God forbid, lost somebody in the attacks, you know, some Israeli that came to America to get away because he was sad. And one of his parents were killed, God forbid. And he's going to see some arrogant person ripping down the poster of another family member that he has that's kidnapped. He might snap, yo. You got to be careful, yo, when you're playing with these things, yo. And to all the Palestinians, yo, if you're good, God will save you. If not, may God destroy you. Like I said, put a curse on your head, like Jeremiah said. Word up. Go read the curse that Jeremiah put on the people of Anatot. And then you will understand what your end is going to be, yo. Starvation, famine, AIDS, something like AIDS. Yeah. What, these people, what do you think? They went and raped girls. You don't think they're going to die of AIDS? A slow death. A vicious virus, yo. Watch. Watch what Hashem is going to do, yo. I know God, man. And he strikes, and he strikes hard. It might take a year. Might take 6 months. Might take 5 years. I guarantee you he will strike. And I really do hope and pray that they do rebuild Gush Katif. I really do, yo. These people got thrown out of their houses by the Israeli government. It's the least Israel can do is overtake Gaza and put them back. And right away, America's, oh, you're not going to overtake it. No, you're not going to tell us what to do. Because when we fight ISIS, when we fight Hamas and destroy them, it helps you. You understand? Get out of here with this garbage, yo. Enough with people telling us what to do. Nobody's going to fight for you like you. You understand? And I'm happy that Hashem put a spirit in the leaders of Israel to finish this mission. Not to give in to any ceasefire. Not to give in to any of these clown negotiations. Nah, yo. And they said that they'll, you know, do a ceasefire if they release all the hostages. I don't have a problem with that. But the minute you get the hostages back, you break that ceasefire and you break their necks. One by one. Make justice, Hashem, please. Let us all see the punishment, yo. That we can see that there is justice in this world. I know there is. But I want the world to see it. I want your children to get closer to you, God. I want your children to love you. I want your children to open up a book of Torah and start crying tears of joy. Thankful that they're able to study the wisdom of your words. That's what I want. I want your children to have compassion, to have mercy. I want your children to stop with all the corruption, with all the arrogance, with all the stiff-necked sins. I want your children to get closer to you. I want your children to love you, to exalt you, to admire you, to sing songs of praises for you, to announce your greatness to the universe, and to say that your kingship is the eternal kingship and everything else is null and void. I want Jews to keep Shabbat and to acknowledge that you made the world in 6 days and rested on the seventh. I want Jews to understand the specialness in a child, the worth of a senior citizen. Just the fact that you can do chesed to an old lady is already a blessing. You're going to tell me why we need old people in the world. That's why. So that we could have the merit to help them and get mitzvot. You understand? Everybody has a purpose. Like I told this one guy, oh, I don't believe in God. I don't believe I have a purpose. So as we were talking, there was an ashtray next to me. And I said to him, this ashtray has a purpose, bro. And you don't? Come on, man. Come on, man. Think about what you're saying. It's so clownish, yo. You know, it's amazing, yo. All these atheists, they talk so big. But if they were in mortal danger, the first one they would call out to is God, yo. Real talk, yo. Shem already told you this, yo. It's the psychology of man. His ego becomes a block for ascension. It cannot rise in spirituality. His ego won't let him. He can't even admit there's a God. And then when he finally admits there's a God, he criticizes him. Oh, I'm more merciful. He says that the gays should die. I have more human rights for gays than God. You're going to be more merciful than God? That's why King Solomon already told you, Al tieh yoter midai tzadik. Don't try to be too righteous, bro. What's right is right, and what's wrong is wrong. Speak on it. I want to shout out Operation Smile, yo. Where they take these kids with like cleft lips and they fix them. God, this one lady, she was so amazing. She wrote such a nice letter. She was like, first I'd like to say thank you to God and to Operation Smile. She was so cute. And she said, what a miracle. And another guy said, my baby is like new. I feel like my baby was just born. He was such a cute kid, yo. And then when they fixed his lip, he was even cuter. Look into the eyes of a baby and see the purity of the love of God. Amen. Hashem, I love you so much, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And I want your children to love you like I do. Protect us, Hashem. Please, we need you. And I want to say a prayer for our soldiers. Please, Hashem, protect them. Protect them like you would Moshe Rabbeinu. Protect them like you did the Jews in the desert. Seven clouds of glory should surround them. Send angels. No, you yourself go on Kadosh Baruch Hu. Because it's in Eretz Yisrael. Protect the soldiers. Save the soldiers. We saw enough death and destruction in our cities. And in our towns. And in our country. We don't want to see any more death for Kadosh Baruch Hu. 37 soldiers, we don't want any more. Please find a way to surround them with the glory of your might. Bring the hostages home, Hashem. Only you can perform a miracle. And if this 9-month-year-old baby comes home fine, then, oh man, what a kiddush Hashem that would be. Or you can hear that all the hostages died. They'll tell you that it was an airstrike. It's not. They murdered them. But they're going to tell you, oh, it was an Israeli airstrike. They killed their own hostages. Just to cause more fights. Yeah. Corruption needs to be eradicated from the earth. My mother's the nicest lady. But when you talk to her about evil, you know what she's going to tell you? Evil, you must wipe it out. You must stomp it out like that, yo. Get rid of it. Destroy it forever. Glorify your name to us, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And remember every nation, like Turkey, even Qatar, that they play footsies with America and footsies with Hamas. remember every nation. I gotta tell him to remember it. He already knows, yo. And he will deal with each one of them. And may you glorify your name to us, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. May you glorify your name to us. I said it 3 times, Chazakah, that it should happen, yo. Bring honor to your name by destroying the wicked. Amen. Love you, Hashem.